Hey guys, Cheryl from Harmony Turbines here, doing a special episode about cold weather. So we had a storm come through here 2 days ago, and here in Lebanon we got probably about 9 inches of snow in a pretty short period of time. I think it was about an inch of snow an hour, and since then we've dropped into some sub-freezing temperatures. We have cold weather advisories. Right now it's 9 o'clock in the morning, and it's 4 degrees outside right now with a wind chill of -6. So this video is going to be pretty short because my hand is not gloved. So anyway, what we wanted to show you is, I'm going to switch over here. All right. So Harmony, we're going to talk about two things here. When we drove in this morning, we noticed something pretty cool about Harmony. With 9 inches of snow dropping pretty heavily 2 days ago, do you see how much is stuck in there in the scoops? None. So we're pretty excited about that. We weren't sure how things would go during a storm like that with accumulation in the scoops. And we get that question a lot, and we've just been saying, we don't know. We'll wait and see what happens. So that's pretty cool. And we were looking at the database data from that day, and the turbine was spinning during the storm. We were having gusts of 6 to 12 mile an hour throughout the storm, and the turbine was spinning as expected. So that was also exciting to see the data around that.
Hey guys, so as Cheryl was talking about, we did actually get data during the storm. So while the snow was really coming down heavy for Lebanon County, although it snowed for a 9 hour period, the bulk of that was in a very tight bell curve of probably 4 hours where we got the heaviest precipitation, the heaviest snowfall, where we got the bulk of our 9 inches of snow in about a 4 hour period. The heaviest part of it was, I would say, from 3 o'clock until 7 perhaps is when the snow was really falling hard. So if we look here on, I have a query written that I'm just showing the wind speed coming in, the RPM, and then this is the date, the 19th, and then 1100 hours, 1113. So the skip's there because we don't collect data when the RPMs are too low. It just, we don't bother writing empty rows to the database or rows that don't matter. So the snow began around 1100. But like I was saying, it got really heavy. Probably this is 2 o'clock, there's 3 o'clock. This is when the snow really started kicking in. And so you see, we were actually getting some pretty good wind 3 o'clock, and we were spinning. In fact, we wouldn't even have the rows in the database if we weren't spinning. So we were getting RPMs. There we got all the way up to, you know, 145 RPM, 10 mile an hour wind. So just letting you know that in the midst of the heavy snow, 3 o'clock, there's 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 1800 hours. You are seeing everything. Now, I ended the query at 1900 hours, which is 7 p.m., but you're seeing the turbine continue to spin throughout that. And I could change this really quick to like 2300 hours for 11 p.m. And you'll see we were still spinning, you know, the snow was done then, but the wind, of course, was continuing to blow. So that was pretty much all the way through the data collection point where I said the turbine kept spinning right on through it. So that's the heaviest snowfall that we got so far. We promised that we would share data with you guys as we got it. Everyone's been like, how's it going to be in the snow? So this is the first we got any snow of any amount to let you see. And the turbine didn't even really have any effect from it. It just kept spinning right on through. So I think more or less by the turbine spinning, it probably kept it from accumulating snow. Now, if it would have been dead wind and it would have been snowing, we'll have to, you know, do another video when that happens. But we were getting some wind while it was snowing. So there's the result of it.
The last thing we want to mention about this scenario here is that with the sub-freezing temperatures now, as of this morning around 5 o'clock a.m., the turbine was still spinning. So, you know, we had sub-freezing temperatures overnight. We will again for the next 2 nights. And right now you can see the anemometers they're going, but it's pretty slow. It's a very casual breeze. It's not quite enough under normal circumstances to kick off Harmony. But we'll be keeping an eye on the data here throughout the day, the next couple days, as we get gusts of wind and seeing how Harmony responds there.
My wife wanted me to show this. This is just up to today. So starting at, you know, today's date is the 22nd. This is 7 a.m. going backwards in time. You know, we are still spinning and everything is fine days after. You know, the sub-freezing temperatures, icing, things like that, we're still continuing to spin. And the turbine really didn't have any ice accumulating on it or anything like that. So I'm just showing you as I'm scrolling through the data here, going, you know, heading down is heading backwards in time in this query. But we are still spinning and producing data.
It's cold and my hand hurts. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Thank you for everyone who has continued following our journey and who continues to support us. And we appreciate each and every one of you. And we're glad to bring you along for this part of our journey. Thanks and have a great week.
Harmony Turbines. We now have the power to change the world.